So, wer schon mal auf die guten Robert Caldwell-Zigarren gestoßen ist, dem werden die speziellen Bilder und Namen auf den Kisten und Banderolen aufgefallen sein. Und da wir hier heute Robert Caldwell bei uns in Berlin haben, in unserem Geschäft, kann er uns natürlich gleich mal erzählen, wie er denn zu diesen einzelnen Kunstwerken kommt. So, I've just said, well, people who buy your cigars, who are interested in them, they have seen the different paintings, the special names. So maybe you can explain us now, where do they come from?
Perfect. So I'm going to focus on these two brands, King is Dead and Long Live the King, today. When we started the company, we wanted to do things very traditionally, but very differently. As many people know and have seen in the American market, you have very large boxes, very large labels, a different approach to the packaging. So we wanted to keep the packaging very simple and traditional in terms of size. With the brands in particular, these two cigars were blended in a very different way. We wanted to have two great, unique cigars, which could be smoked independently. But something else that happens when you smoke cigars, oftentimes you'll smoke a first cigar, and then the second cigar that you smoke following that cigar will taste different because the effect that the first cigar has on your palate. So we spent a lot of time on the blends, blending two cigars, which would be unique, independently, but also very complementary to each other. So King is Dead would be followed by Long Live the King. So we came up with a brand concept, the King is Dead, Long Live the King. So King is Dead should be your primary cigar that you smoke, following that cigar with Long Live the King. And again, they smoke independently, very unique, beautiful cigars. But if you smoke them together, Long Live the King should taste better or more enhanced because the effect that King is Dead has left on your palate.
Uh-huh. And the paintings, where do they come from?
The paintings were concepts of ours. So King is Dead, very hard idea to come up with some artwork for that. So we took a throne and then cracked the throne in half to symbolize the king having died. And then Long Live the King, a more youthful king to fill his seat.
And the artist, where do...
This artist is named Evoca One. He's a Miami-based artist. Amazing. I met him about 5 years ago, and we started off as just friends. The guy was trying to become an artist, a very talented kid, and we supported him from the very beginning. And now he's a very established, big, well-known artist, and he's continued to work with us the whole time. So really beautiful artist, does tremendous work.
Thanks, Robert. Ich werde nur kurz was hinzufügen, was uns Robert vorher schon erzählt hat. Und zwar hat er am Anfang, als er begonnen hat im Zigarrenbusiness, in einem Künstlerviertel, so wie früher Kreuzberg mal in Berlin, gewohnt und ist da natürlich mit vielen Künstlern in Kontakt gekommen, hat sich mit ein paar angefreundet. Und einer dieser Künstler macht eben dieses Kistendesign auch, kommt auf die ganzen Ideen. Und der ist heute auch richtig erfolgreich, muss man sagen. Ja, soviel zu den Bildern und zu den Namen der Caldwell-Zigarren.